I'm Kevin Hogan, president of Rock Island Auction Company. Because of the phenomenal and deep auction we have for you coming up April 29th, 30th, and May 1st, we have the unique pleasure of viewing four phenomenal rarities in the field of 19th century American firearms collecting. And what we're looking at here is a collaboration between the famed jeweler Tiffany and Company and two of the great names in American firearms manufacturing, Colt and Smith & Wesson. The fact that we have three different variations here in Colt's and one in Smith & Wesson's is pretty unbelievable. The only opportunity that you would have as a collector, investment buyer, a fan of history, or just a general gun enthusiast to see this diversity would be to visit the Metropolitan Museum of Art, and that's the only other place that you could see the scope and the differences between the work that Tiffany did for the firearms designers. So to start here, we'll start with the Colts. What collectors recognize are three different variations of grips that Tiffany did in collaboration with Colt. They were all cast in bronze, and then they would be gilded in either silver or gold. But I just don't want to understate the fact that we have the three variations here, not just on this table, but offered for sale. You can come hold them in your hands, you can come look at them, and if you're motivated enough, you can put them in your own collection. So we'll start here on the right. We'll view this 1862 police revolver engraved by the hand or the shop of Louis D. Nimsky. These weren't done at the factory. They were done in New York in collaboration, again, with Tiffany on the grips. And this is what collectors, experts will identify as the American Eagle or the Mexican Eagle cast grip. You can see the eagle here on the back strap. Nice details in the vine work going all the way up. Kind of bulbous here at the end, but a really beautiful example. This is the scarcest of the three. But again, the engraving is not done in the factory. It's done by Nimsky, but a really unique opportunity to see the rare Tiffany grip. From the 62 police, we'll transition to the 51 Navy. Now, this 51 Navy features what they call the battle scene grip. This is the most common of the three, but I don't want to understate that none of these are common. The battlefield will be on both sides of the grip. And something I might point out to collectors that are interested or do see these on a gun show table is that these are faked heavily. Just like bronzes, they can cast a casting. So what it really comes down to is the details in the casting itself. So if you see one at a gun show, if you get one offered to you, make sure you're really looking at it because it's all in the details. So here on this 51 Navy, we looked at the battlefield grip, but what's really unique too is the engraving on the revolver itself, which was executed no doubt by the hand of Louis D. Nimsky. If you go on his pull book to page 33, you will see it has his signature arrow here on the barrel, but if you compare the barrel to the pull, the pull was taken from this barrel. To go a little bit further, it has the ultra luxurious gold finish, deluxe engraving on the loading lever, just a really beautiful, very rare 19th century American revolver. You don't have to be a Colt collector. It's actually a good way to get your wife into collecting guns, to buy her some Tiffany. So we'll go from the 51, we'll go to the 62 police. Again, between the Mexican and the American Eagle grip, we have this one, which is considered classed by collectors and experts as the missionary and child. You can see it's cast in bronze, and you will see the majority of these in bronze. Again, these two are far scarcer than the battle scene gun. This is a very famous gun, actually. It's photographed everywhere. Again, it's taken from Nimsky's pull book. This was done and executed by his hand. The entire revolver, starting with the frame and moving all the way to the tip of the muzzle, you will see in the pull book every engraving motif, every angle, the cylinder, the hammer, the frame, the barrel, the loading lever is in the pull book itself. It's photographed in the first few pages of the book, and it's also on the cover. So if you're looking for a very, very rare, solid representative, well-known icon, this is it. Moving a little bit later, approximately 1890, this is 1860. 1890, we see Smith & Wesson collaborate with Tiffany. This is a very, very unique and quite incredible little 32 caliber Smith & Wesson revolver. We'll talk about it later in another video. But this work was done by Tiffany. It was in the factory letter. It was shipped from Smith & Wesson to Tiffany & Company of New York, where it was embellished with this beautiful silver grip. What makes this gun even more special is that, it's marked Tiffany, but two, it was one of the display guns for Smith & Wesson at the 1893 Chicago World's Fair. It was one of four guns that Smith & Wesson commissioned Tiffany to do for their display. Kind of unique here is that we sold this gun approximately 10 years ago, and it comes back again. And what's even more interesting is that the gun was initially discovered in Chicago. So you have the 1893 World's Fair in Chicago, where Smith & Wesson puts on this display. It was probably sold at the fair where it resided in Chicago for the rest of its life until it came to Rock Island Auction approximately 10 years ago. It was sold to a collector on the West Coast, and we're fortunate enough to offer it back to the collecting fraternity. But a phenomenal rarity in the field of 19th century American firearms collecting. And kind of give you the history here on the other two guns. Both of these came from a different West Coast collector, and the 51 Navy comes prominently from the Robert Brotherton collection, which we're excited to have. I hope you enjoyed this video. It's a unique opportunity again to examine a great collaboration between a famous jeweler and two of the most famous firearms designers of the 19th century.